Hi, this is Manos Brilakis, and this is case 115 for the Manual of Percutaneous Coronary Interventions. This is a case of a provisional bifurcation PCI that required troubleshooting. The target lesion was a Medina 010 bifurcation of the circumflex and the obtuse marginal branch. If we look at the bifurcation treatment algorithm, the first question is whether the side branch, the OM in this case, needs to be preserved. And clearly, this is a very large vessel and clearly needs to be preserved. The second question is, what is the likelihood of occluding the side branch? And actually, in this case, the likelihood seems to be low. There is no significant disease at the ostium of the side branch. So in this case, a provisional stenting strategy is preferred. This is what was done. The lesion was predilated, and then a stent was placed across the ostium of the obtuse marginal branch. Retrospectively, the stent length was a little short because we should have at least 6 to 8 millimeters of stent proximal to the bifurcation to enable performance of the proximal optimization technique. The other factor when selecting stents, and there is a size discrepancy between the distal and the proximal main vessel, is to make sure we choose a stent that can be expanded to the diameter of the proximal main vessel. For example, if in this case we thought that the distal main vessel is 3, but the proximal is 4 millimeters, then if we used a 3.0 millimeter or 0, for example, then we could not expand it to 4 millimeters. And one solution to that is to use, for example, a synergy that can go up to 4.0 millimeters. Another option would be to use a slightly larger stent, such as a 3.5, that can then be deployed at a low pressure and then post-dilated proximally at a larger diameter. After the stent was placed, the result into the circumflex seems to be okay. However, there is some pinching of the ostium of the obtuse marginal branch. Is this significant or is it not? And sometimes for those side branches, it can be challenging to tell by angiography alone. So one way to be more accurate in whether there is need for more PCI is to use a pressure wire to determine if there is a significant disease of the ostium. And in this particular case, the pressure wire, an obstent wire, was advanced into the obtuse marginal branch. This can be sometimes difficult given that the side branch is jailed, but eventually it was successful. And then the DPR was 0.72. So restic hyperemic index is in the ischemic range. So clearly we have here a significant pinching of the ostium of the obtuse marginal branch, and therefore something more needs to be done given how large this branch is. We had a little difficulty here. The pressure wire would not come back. And the key thing when this happens is to not pull hard, because that may lead to rupture of the wire and that creates a worse problem. The solution is to advance a balloon or microcatheter as far down as possible, and that provides more leverage for pulling back the wire and often frees the wire from the point where it's been entrapped. And that's exactly what happened here. We advanced a small balloon and it looks like the wire had gone under the struts of the stent, and that is why it could not come back. And then by putting the balloon far down, we were able to successfully remove the guide wire. The result also in the circumflex did not look that great. There seems to be a filling defect now into the circumflex. Makes us wonder whether we deformed the stent by trying to advance the pressure wire and then a balloon to release it. So we post-dilated with a 3.0 millimeter balloon. It still does not look great. And then we did a kissing balloon inflation, placing a balloon into the OM as well as into the circumflex. And here is the kissing balloon inflation. Here our stent proximal was relatively short, but we were still able to get the two balloons protruding partially back from the side branch into the main vessel. And that was how it looked like after the kissing balloon and the proximal optimization with a 3.0 by 6 millimeter balloon. And we did again pressure wire measurement, and actually the DPR was 0.93, so we're no longer ischemic. Although we'd like this to be 0.94, this was deemed to be good enough and the case was stopped. So this is a case of provisional stenting in which a stent was placed over the ostium of the side branch, but then the side branch became compromised as shown by the pressure wire, and that was solved by doing balloon angioplasty, kissing balloon inflation, and rePOT. So in summary, for most bifurcations, a provisional strategy is preferred when the side branch is significant but the risk of compromising the flow is low. When doing provisional, it is very important to ensure there is enough stent length proximally to allow performing the proximal optimization technique. If there is a question about the side branch compromise after the main vessel stent is deployed, using a pressure wire can help assess the severity of the disease at the origin of the side branch. And finally, if there is difficulty pulling wires back, the key thing is to not pull hard to prevent the wire from fracturing, but instead advance a small balloon or a microcatheter and then pull, the balloon and microcatheter can help free up the wire. Thank you very much.